It's Nick Avocado, your favorite American mukbanger.
This is professional mukbanger Nikocado Avocado. This is Nikocado in 2016, and this is him now. In just 5 short years, Nikocado has morphed from the slim vegan violinist he was into the huge YouTube drama persona he is today, both figuratively and physically. If you know anyone who's let themselves go, whether it's after a career or romantic loss, then you know that one of the first things that happens is the consumption of comfort foods. This tendency can be explained by evolutionary biology, which theorizes that elevated stress hormone levels cause the body to crave food, as if needing to store up on energy to protect itself from an impending threat. In the caveman days, this was an effective strategy to help ward off starvation in times of dire need. But in Nikocado's case, it's his entire career. Whether it's taking on Matt Stoney's 10,000 calorie Flamin' Hot Cheetos challenge or eating his entire body weight in Taco Bell, the famous mukbanger is no stranger to downing massive quantities of unhealthy substances. His $100 worth of Sonic challenge alone equated to roughly 6,700 calories, 365 grams of fat, and 15,700 milligrams of sodium. This drastic transformation in both diet and weight can have a huge impact on both your mental and physical health. Now weighing in at over 330 pounds, Nikocado has likely doubled in body weight since his vegan days in 2016, leading to a host of noted health issues, the least of which include a possible heart attack, incontinence on multiple occasions, facial and bodily acne, and translucent teeth. However, contrary to popular belief, it isn't just the amount of food that he eats that's the problem, it's the kinds of foods as well. While it's debatable whether or not veganism is the right diet for everyone, Nikocado's prior diet did have some notable health benefits. For example, a review on medical literature found that plant-based diets had a significant impact in promoting weight loss, increasing energy levels, and reducing bodily inflammation in both healthy and obese participants. One of veganism's greatest strengths is a reduction in a person's intake of saturated fats. Eating too much saturated fat can cause insulin resistance, which means that your body's cells can't draw the energy you obtain from the food you eat in the form of glucose. This can cause chronic fatigue, and since your body's cells are technically hungry all the time, because they can't access your energy stores, you become hungry as well, resulting in a destructive feedback loop of eating, but never feeling completely satisfied or energized, and then eating again to try and satisfy yourself. It's a borderline epidemic, with over 100 million people in the United States alone. That's 1 in 3 people suffering from insulin resistance in the form of pre-diabetes or type 2 diabetes. While it does have its benefits, some people do react negatively to veganism, as Nikocado himself reported symptoms like hair loss, tooth decay, vitamin B12 deficiency, hypoglycemia, and impaired memory and concentration. These symptoms aren't uncommon either. Vegans are especially at risk for iron-deficient anemia, which can lead to serious symptoms mentioned earlier, like fatigue, hair loss, and brain fog. Because of this, in 2017, Nikocado announced his departure from veganism and the vegan mukbangs he was doing at the time. And while some people might attribute Nikocado's remarkable weight gain to his switch from veganism to non-veganism, the truth is actually much simpler than you think. Nikocado himself attributes his putting on the pounds to consuming soy, sugar, and grains. If you look at his eating history, it's easy to verify this statement. But the craziest part about Nikocado's diet isn't just how bad it is, but how common it is in America. Known as the Standard American Diet, or SAD for short, this food pyramid created by big American grains companies and the USDA in the 1970s emphasizes ultra-processed foods rich in, you guessed it, soy, sugar, and grains. If you pull up any graphs on obesity trends, you can see a very noticeable uptick around 1977, eventually leading up to the USA's current obesity problem. Soy is especially bad for you. This is because soy can disrupt your hormones, specifically acting as estrogen, which can cause a multitude of health problems including breast cancer, acne due to imbalanced hormones, male infertility, and estrogen dominance, which can even lead to the development of gynecomastia, or breast tissue in men. Most well known for its presence in Asian cuisine and in alternate forms of protein like tofu, soy milk, and imitation meat products, soy is also found in large quantities inside almost every form of processed or canned food in North America. This includes everything from baked goods like breads, cookies, and crackers, to canned broths and soups, to canned tuna or meat, and even cereals. Also, high-protein energy bars and snacks, peanut butter, deli meats, and various sauces and dressings. Luckily, avoiding soy isn't all that difficult. The key is eating whole foods and organic grass-fed animals as your protein sources. Next is the sugar. Did you know it's as bad as alcohol? You may already know that 80 to 90% of the alcohol you consume is metabolized by the liver. The 10% that makes its way to your brain is responsible for the drunk or tipsy experience. This is why many alcoholics tend to suffer liver damage from repeated alcohol abuse and experience chronic conditions like hypertension, heart disease, obesity, fatty liver disease, and pancreatitis. But what if there was a drink that was like alcohol, but was entirely metabolized by your liver? You wouldn't feel drunk or tipsy in the moment, but would still experience the long-term health effects associated with alcoholism. Would you give a drink like this to your kids? Unfortunately, a drink like this does exist, in the form of soda. More specifically, it's the sugar found in soda and many other consumables that creates the same symptoms as repeated alcohol abuse over time, but without the instant gratification of feeling tipsy. With Nikocado reportedly experiencing heart disease as early as age 27, it's clear that his high sugar intake isn't doing him any favors. Finally, the grains. While not inherently bad for you, too much consumption of grains, especially in the form of refined carbohydrates, can really mess you up. Bad or simple carbohydrates include sugars and refined grains that have been stripped of all bran, fiber, and nutrients, such as white bread, pizza dough, pasta, pastries, white flour, white rice, sweet desserts, and many breakfast cereals. They digest quickly, and their high glycemic index causes unhealthy spikes in blood sugar levels. They can also cause a buildup of fat, especially around your waistline. Not only does this impact Nikocado's physical health, but research shows that diet is inextricably linked to one's mood and mental health too. Could Nikocado Avocado's mukbang diet be frying his brain? One 2019 study found that an increase in consumption of whole foods while decreasing consumption of processed foods led to a decrease in people's levels of anxiety and depression. Another study found that people who regularly consume fast food are 51% more likely to develop depression. Ironically, comfort foods can actually make you feel worse. Studies show that a calorie-rich but nutrient-lacking diet full of processed foods, refined carbohydrates, and trans fat can cause emotional instability and an inability to regulate or control those emotions. This can mean very fast and very large mood swings, much like the roller coaster ride of emotions Nikocado seems to experience in each video. But the relationship between these comfort foods and how they affect your mood is actually dose-dependent. So maybe a happy meal here and there won't hurt, but downing $100 worth of McDonald's in one sitting might explain some of Nikocado's rowdier antics. It isn't just your mood either. Eating excess amounts of junk food can also give you what's called food fatigue. Famously labeled the itis in the animated hit TV show The Boondocks, food fatigue can happen when you eat too much refined sugar or when the bacterial balance in your intestines gets out of whack. Your gut's microbiome has been called the second brain and has a lot of control on how we feel and think. Increased intake of trans fat has been shown to increase feelings of irritability, aggression, and impair our ability to properly regulate or express our emotions. Sound familiar? Other studies show that eating a high-fat, nutrient-poor diet for as little as 5 days can impair attention, memory, and mood. But the reverse is also true. In a review of 16 studies with over 46,000 participants, researchers found that adopting a healthier diet, eating more whole foods, and decreasing processed ones drastically improved mood and reduced feelings like hopelessness, anxiety, and other depressive-like symptoms. To give you even more hope, a study done in Aylesbury Jail in the UK measured the inmate-on-inmate violence both when they were and weren't supplementing essential nutrients and fatty and amino acids into their diets. Prisons aren't exactly known for having the most nutritionally dense meals after all. What they found was shocking. Over the two-year trial, the researchers found that when prisoners were properly supplemented with the right vitamins, fatty acids, and amino acids, the violent crime rate in the prison fell by 37%. But after the study ended and the prisoners resumed their regular diets, the violent crime rate rose back up to its previous level. This both explains Nikocado's more violent moments and provides a solution for his erratic behavior, which is simply, eat a good diet and supplement what you need. One thing that Nico always says in his videos is that he's full of water weight. While humorous, it does hold an ounce of truth. Nikocado's mukbang diet is full of sodium or salt, which can cause him to retain water weight. Eating a healthier diet with less sodium and rich in other minerals like potassium and zinc can even out his electrolyte balance and flush out the excess fluid. Aside from implementing a diet rich in whole foods, proper supplementation of deficient nutrients is also highly beneficial. Supplementing omega-3 may help, as it's been shown to not only lower inflammation and anxiety, but improve some mental disorders and protect against cognitive impairment. You can find omega-3 in fatty fish, walnuts, flax, and supplements. Interested in learning more about diet and how to lose weight? Check out our other video on how Matt Stoney stays slim to find out more. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and share it with your friends. For more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and remember to click on the notification bell. Also, be sure to check out our other videos as well. Thanks for watching!